Hello and welcome. I am so glad you're here. So today's topic is about summer vacations. As a spa owner, is it possible for you to take a full month off of work and not be at the spa, not be managing your team, and actually enjoying your own downtime? Well, if it sounds too good to be true, that may have been the case in the past, but dear spa owner, I want you to know that it is actually possible. Now, that doesn't mean that there isn't some work that needs to be done in order to make this happen. Because traditionally in the spa industry, because we are service providers, even if you are leading a team and not in the treatment room, it's not like we can, you know, close the doors and walk away and still generate revenue. We don't have that kind of business. So what it means is that particularly as a team, and even more so as a solo, that we need to have definitely have structure to our business, but we need to have systems in our business that allows us to do things like keep marketing, keep income coming in if we're not at work. So I want to talk about teams first, and I'm not going to forget about you solos, because although it is a little bit trickier to take the time off, it's not impossible. Okay, so most spa owners decided to become a spa owner because you wanted flexibility in your schedule. You wanted flexibility to go after and to work with the type of clients that you want to work with, to work in the niche that you want to work with or work in. And so entrepreneurship, it seemed like it was going to be a really good opportunity to have that flexibility. But as we know, once we get into this, that's not really how it ends up playing out. And what does end up playing out is that usually whether you're a team or solo, you don't have a lot of systems in place in your business, and you are the chief cook and bottle washer, meaning you are doing most things, especially in that leadership role. And so what the problem is that if you took yourself out of that position of doing all the things, things would fall apart if you took a month off work. So yeah, absolutely. Right now, it's probably not a good idea to like close the doors and take a vacation. So this conversation could very possibly be, and I'm hoping it will be, a place for you to start thinking about how you're going to do this for next year, because you're going to need some time to put together your systems and your structure. All right, so this is coming from a book that I like to call workshopped. And what I mean by that is a lot of times I will take a business book and I will not just do a read through and, you know, take a few pieces of information and make some changes in my business. I will not only just read through the book, but I will study the book and do the homework and all the actions needed. And so it was probably about 2 years ago now that I workshopped this book with my bestie Esty. We did this together. And so what the book I'm talking about is, and you've probably seen it before, I've talked about it before, it's Run Like Clockwork by Mike Michalowicz. I know that in the spa industry, he is a favorite. I know that Daniela has featured some of his books, and I believe Maxine has as well. I think Maxine's actually had him on doing a workshop. But this, he's got lots of books. Profit First is another favorite of mine. I actually have a Profit First accounting firm that does all my accounting for me in the Profit First methodology. Love this book, Run Like Clockwork, because the whole point of the book is about how to get your business to run like clockwork so that you can take 6 weeks off work from your business. So that's where this concept came for me, and I did the work. Now, what happened was last year, if you've been following me for this long, last year in September, my son was in a near fatal car accident, and I had to be off work for a month. And so while it was not planned, it was an emergency, I literally had to drop everything and you know, take care of my son. And I mentally didn't have the bandwidth to focus on work. I physically could not be present to work. And so the beauty of all of the time and energy I put into building systems in my business was that when I really needed it last September, I was able to pass my work off to Delia, my director of marketing. And our clients did not know that I was not in the mix for at least a month. They had no idea. So for us, having that emergency was actually the acid test to see if our systems and our structure actually supported running like clockwork without me being there. And it did. It was amazing. So what that showed me after I was able to kind of come out of the fog of my son's accident and the healing portion of it, I realized, oh, wow, actually that worked pretty darn good. And you know what? Next summer in 2021, I want to take a month off of work, not because I have to, but because I want to. So this July in a few weeks, I am taking off the month of July from my business. And I'm only able to do that because I have the structure set up of my business. I've got the right team, the right people in the right places. And there are systems. So people know what they're supposed to be doing on a regular, consistent basis. There's no surprises and there's accountability all over the place. So, so as far as you, dear spa owner, how do you take a full month off of work? Well, let's talk about that. First of all, if this is piquing your interest, I definitely recommend getting this book and reading it. So you don't necessarily need to workshop it right out of the gate, but absolutely read it to understand the concepts that he's talking about, because they are so solid and they're easy to understand. You don't have to have an MBA to understand this stuff. It's logical. And the author writes it in a way that's really easy to understand. Okay. So I wanted to pull out a few little nuggets from this book that I feel will give you a little heads up as far as how does this work. All right. So the first piece I want to share with you from this book is that he'll have you analyzing your time. And one of the reasons why I wanted to talk about this is because with my private coaching clients, all of them, I'm trying to think if there's any one of them that hasn't had this issue, but all of them have the same issue. And that is they are the bottleneck in their business. And you know what? I'm going to go out on a limb and say that I still tend to sometimes be the bottleneck if I'm getting in the way of my own systems. So it's really common as the leader in your business to be the bottleneck, because we've run up this industry as service providers. So we're used to being in the weeds. We're used to knowing all the things and having our hands in the mix. But as we grow in our business and our leadership needs to grow and our team grows, even if you're solo, if you are really busy in your schedule, you need a team. You need somebody to help you with admin. You need somebody probably to help you with your housekeeping and grocery shopping. And you probably need a bookkeeper. You probably need somebody helping you with your marketing. So you should not be doing all of those things. So of course, yes, as a solo, you are the bottleneck if you're not seeing that you should be outsourcing at this point. So both solos and teams, if you are the bottleneck, I'm going to say that you are because you probably are. What he has you doing is he has you analyzing your time and putting it into what he calls the 4D mix. And it's essentially breaking up your time into four different categories. Doing, which is what I call like being in the weeds, just like, you know, doing your social media management, working on a client. So that's doing stuff. Then we have delivering the tasks. Then we have delegating. And then we, at the very top, we have designing. So he'll share with you that you as the leader need to be spending most of your time in the designing part of your business. So most of your time needs to be in that area. What this little exercise has you do, and it's a real eye opener, let me tell you, is, and he actually has a little spreadsheet for you that you can download. So if you bought the book, there's some digital resources that are complimentary to you, and you can download the spreadsheet for this 4D mix and track your time for a week. You just need to do it for a week. And it will be glaringly obvious that you are spending way too much time doing things rather than delegating and designing. So that's the first part, is a time analysis to really shine the light on, you know, the stuff that you're spending time on that you probably shouldn't be spending time on. Okay. The second piece that I love, the second point I love about his book, is that he identifies and has you identify, and there's really great exercises in the book to help you identify what the queen bee role is in your business. Now, the queen bee role is just that. So if you know anything about beehives and bee behaviors, then he's basically using the hive as a model for business. And it's brilliant, because in the hive, without the queen bee, the hive would collapse. Now, without you, dear spa owner, your business would collapse. But here's the really important piece. There's probably only one thing that you do really, really well that generates the most business in your business. And so that is the queen bee role. What is the thing that you can do that cannot be replaced, that brings in and generates that income for you? So it might take you a little bit at this section of the book to figure out truly what your queen bee role is. It took me a little while to separate all of the stuff that I do. What is it that I really do that if I didn't do, the business would fall apart? Or what is it that I do that my other team members can't do and the business will fall apart? So what I identified was that in my business, it's high level strategy. If I wasn't here doing high level strategy, then the rest of the business would collapse, because that's what I provide to my clients. With the done for you services side of the business, it's still strategy. That's the queen bee role. Now, because we have these two very, very different sides to our business, I have the queen bee role in the coaching and consulting, but Delia, my director of marketing, is starting to develop her own queen bee role on that side of the business. So she's not quite there yet in terms of being able to take over the full business at this point, but she's getting very, very close as far as the digital agency side. So that just tells me as the leader that this is what we're doing, is we're developing out that queen bee role for the agency side for Delia. So looking at this from a spa perspective, what is your queen bee role? For skin therapy, perhaps it's the fact that you are the skin strategist. So it's going to just take a little bit of time to really think about what you do, but it's so valuable, because once you nail this, it absolutely helps to open up how you and which systems you need to develop. Now, once there's more to this book than just the 4D time mix and the queen bee role, but those are the two biggest takeaways that I wanted to share with you in terms of what do I need to figure out in order to set up the structure and systems in my spa business so that I could actually take time off and not have to worry about what my team is doing or how the business is being managed. So if I piqued your interest and you're like, oh my gosh, a month off next summer, maybe that would be wonderful, then absolutely get yourself this book, Run Like Clockwork, just clockwork, and start reading, have it be your summer read. In these kinds of books, I'm constantly marking up my book. I'm highlighting, I've got little sticky notes as tabs. Use it as a workbook. There's enough information in there for you to do that. So once you finish reading the book Clockwork and you've started making some notes and all that kind of stuff, what's next? Well, time to start working on your spa business system. Start putting those together so that you can take a full month off next summer. So I plan on where my husband and I are heading out camping for a couple of weeks for the first couple of weeks of July. And then the second half of July, I wanted to have a little at-home staycation and just putter in my garden. And I want to repaint my kitchen cabinets. But it's my intention to have the full month of July off, first time to actually really enjoy that. And everything's set up to make that happen. And I want that for you too, because I know as a spa owner, you are tired. There's a lot of output all year long with clients, with team, but it's possible. Oh, I just about forgot to talk about solo spa owners. So let me talk about that just before I log off here. So if you are a solo spa owner and you want to take a month off of your work next summer, it's definitely possible. You will likely have to close because you are the person doing the services. But if what you want to do in order to make sure that you're earning the same amount of money in the whole year as you would like in 11 months versus 12 months, then where you make this change is in your yearly planning. So, in November, when you're starting to plan for 2022, make your sales goals. You would have to just divide them up into 11 months, not 12 months. And then that way you are making sure that you're generating the revenue you want to make in the full year, but you're just doing it in 11 months. So yeah, it's going to be a little bit more challenging. That means that you'll have higher sales goals in your other months, but that is how you make sure that you can take a month off. I know a couple of solo spa owners who take the whole summer off because they have little kids and they've just trained their clients that they're not available for the summer. And that's just kind of how it goes. Clients are fairly adaptable that way, especially when they really, really love what you do. Okay, if you have any questions or any comments, I would love to hear them. If you enjoy this podcast, I would really appreciate it if you left me a review. And if you do want to connect with me, you can do so on any of my social channels, on Facebook with Kirsten Foss Coaching, on Instagram, and you can certainly email me at kirsten@kirstenfoss.com. All right, that's it for me today. We'll see you next week.